Oregon Trail, the legendary historic highway of the pioneer wagon trains of the 1800s.
Yes, we'll be on the actual Oregon Trail as we go through here.
Today, you can ride an authentic covered wagon or ride a horse as an outrider on the same ground where all those wagons roll, thanks to Historic Trails West.
What I really enjoy is giving the people that come out the experience and giving them an opportunity to get a little feel about it.
Hop in the wagon, hit the trail, and you quickly realize this was one rough ride. But the fact is, very few pioneers actually rode in the wagons. Most of the men, women, and children walked to lighten the load for their precious oxen, mules, or horses that pulled those wagons, 10 to 15 miles a day for 5 months.
I have a tremendous amount of respect for those that made the trip. And then we read in the visitor center that one out of five women were pregnant when they made the trip, and it just blows our mind.
We did the whole thing.
In 1993, Morris Carter took four wagons on the entire 2,600-mile Oregon Trail.
The first 30 days out of the first 31 days were rain, hail, and tornadoes.
During the 150th anniversary of the very first wagon train that rolled west in 1843.
My mother was a homesteader's daughter that grew up driving teams.
Wagon training runs in his blood.
My grandfather drove 12 head of horses pulling two wagons on what was called a jerkline team.
It's often debated just what kind of wagons were actually used back in the day.
And so I asked old timers, they said, whatever you make will be just as authentic as what they did, because many of them made their own wagon.
Morris built this wagon and the other three he used on the trip to Oregon.
And in the heyday of the trail, there were 2,000 wagon makers.
Get up there, Mike. And Mike's kind of our lazy got horse. He doesn't like to pull as much, and Jordan, he's kind of the hog.
Today, his niece Jamie Forbes holds the reins on our ride.
Well, I've helped my uncle for 28 years. So Jordan, he'll pull too much, and Mike don't pull enough. Most of our ancestors come over on the Oregon Trail.
Historic Trails West offers 3 to 5 day wagon train overnight adventures that follow the actual trail, complete with a river crossing. Or you can take a 2 to 3 hour day ride. Either way, you'll learn some history about the trail.
They come in and make a big oval because that's how they made their trails, so they didn't have to go round them up every morning.
There's also an option to stay for dinner, spend the night in a teepee, and learn a little about pioneer cooking with a Dutch oven.
And it was called an oven because you had fire underneath, fire on top, and then another one on top of it. So it was actually heating from the top and the bottom.
What kind of horses are they?
These are Percheron horses. So this is one of the type of horse that's bred to pull. Easy boy.
How'd you guys like your trip on the Oregon Trail?
Just incredible.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
A little bumpy.
A little bumpy, but very interesting.
Mike, Jordan, up. Watch it, boys.
During the 1800s, an estimated 500,000 people made the dangerous and often deadly trek on the Oregon Trail. Thousands died along the way.
They were tough, and they got a lot tougher.
But those pioneers also experienced a unique time and place in the history of the American West.
The 1843 wagon train wrote about having to wait 2 days for the buffalo to go by so they could continue on.
And now you can get a taste of what that was like, riding an authentic covered wagon on the real Oregon Trail.